shall discuss now about the nervous system of rabbit. Nervous system in rabbit, it is formed of central nervous system, that is CNS, peripheral nervous system, that is PNS, and autonomic nervous system, which is called ANS. Okay, central nervous system in rabbit, it is of three systems: CNS or central nervous system, PNS or peripheral nervous system, and ANS or autonomic nervous system. CNS means it refers to, that is that includes brain and spinal cord. Okay, it refers to central nervous system. CNS refers to central nervous system. It includes brain and spinal cord. PNS refers to peripheral nervous system, and it is formed of 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 37 pairs of spinal nerves. Okay, PNS, it includes 12 pairs of cranial nerves. Cranial, it refers to brain. Okay, nerves that arise from brain are called cranial nerves. So rabbit has 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 37 pairs of spinal nerves. Nerves that arise from spinal cord are called spinal nerves. So totally 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 37 pairs of spinal nerves arise. Okay, so all these nerves are included under this peripheral nervous system. And this is autonomic nervous system. It comprises, or it consists of, sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. Okay, so we shall discuss now about the brain of in detail about the brain of a rabbit. It is situated in a cavity, that is a cranial cavity, and it is covered by three membranes. Okay, brain is situated inside that is a cavity called cranial cavity, or also called skull, and it is covered by three membranes. The outermost membrane that is very close to skull or cranium is called dura mater. Okay, the outermost membrane that is close to the that is cranium or the skull is called dura mater, and innermost membrane, which is called pia mater, and the middle arachnoid membrane. Okay, there are three membranes, which are dura mater, pia mater, and arachnoid membrane. Okay, dura mater. Okay, mater, you try to remember, no double T, only single T. Mater, not matter. Okay, double T. So dura mater is an outer membrane, and the innermost membrane is pia mater, and middle is arachnoid membrane. And brain is divided into three regions or three parts: forebrain, which is called prosencephalon; midbrain, which is called mesencephalon; and hindbrain, which is called rhombencephalon. Okay, we shall discuss now in detail, and this is the picture. So this is the forebrain. It includes olfactory lobes. Okay, these two lobes are called olfactory lobes. They are connected to a sense of smell. Okay, they are the organs of smell. Okay, and these are the two hemispheres, which are called cerebral hemispheres. The cerebral hemispheres form cerebrum. Okay, and these cerebral hemispheres are connected at the base by a band of nervous tissue called corpus callosum. Okay, and another part, which is called diencephalon, okay, that lies below the cerebrum. So these olfactory lobes, cerebral hemispheres, and diencephalon, all these three parts come under forebrain or prosencephalon. Then this part, this is called optic lobes, which lie below this forebrain. They come under, or they form the midbrain or middle brain, also called mesencephalon. And the last one, which is called the hindbrain, also called rhombencephalon, it includes cerebellum, pons veroli, and medulla oblongata. Okay, this very easy, not much informations are given. So brain of rabbit is divided into three parts: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain consists of three parts: olfactory lobes, cerebral hemispheres, and diencephalon. Midbrain consists of optic lobes. Hindbrain consists of cerebellum, pons veroli, and medulla oblongata. In addition to that, remember, cerebral hemispheres, there are two halves, which are connected at the base by a band of nervous tissue called corpus callosum. Very simple also, this diagram, please go through it. And this is the information what I explained already. So forebrain consists of a pair of olfactory lobes and cerebral hemispheres and diencephalon. Right and left cerebral hemispheres are connected by a transverse band of nervous tissue called corpus callosum. And I told already, midbrain includes optic lobes, and hindbrain consists of cerebellum, pons veroli, and medulla oblongata. We shall move on to the next system. This is called urinogenital system. Okay, human beings, there are well developed vertebrate animals, that is the mammals. They have a separate excretory system and reproductive system are separate. But in these animals, some lower organisms like this, they have a clubbed system of both excretory and reproductive system. So this system is called urinogenital system. Excretory system and reproductive system are together. They are associated with each other. So this system is called urinogenital system. Many animals have urinogenital system. Unlike mammals, where unlike human beings, we have separate excretory system and reproductive system or genital system. So here it comprises of urinary or excretory system and the genital or reproductive system. As I said, urogenital system, it refers to it's a combined systems of urinary or excretory system and genital or reproductive system. Therefore, they are usually described as urinogenital system in vertebrates. So vertebrate animals where both the systems are together, they are called urinogenital system. So this is about the excretory system. Excretory system consists of kidneys, a pair of kidneys, and each kidney is made up of several nephrons. Each kidney is made up of several nephrons. These nephrons are the excretory in function. They are the functional unit of the excretory system called nephrons. It separates the each kidney does is it separates the nitrogenous waste from blood and excretes it in the form of urea. Kidney is excretory in function. It helps to remove the waste from the nitrogenous waste from the body. That is done by these nephrons. Each kidney is made up of several nephrons. These nephrons help the kidneys to separate out nitrogenous waste. Nitrogenous waste from the blood are removed and excreted in the form of urea. And kidneys are dark red bean-shaped organs. They are situated in the abdominal cavity. Kidneys are dark red bean-shaped organs situated in the abdominal cavity. From each kidney arises the ureters. From each kidney arises ureters, tube-like structures. They are tubular and they open posteriorly into the urinary bladder. And urinary bladder, from that it leads into a thick-walled muscular duct called urethra. So this is the structure, this is the picture to show the urinogenital system of rabbit. Here it is the picture that shows the male urinogenital system. So as I said, these are the kidneys, which are paired organs and bean shaped and dark red in color. And from each kidney arises, these are the tubular structures which are called ureters. Ureters open into this bladder, urinary bladder. Urinary bladder opens outside through this urethra. So this is about the excretory system in rabbit. So in the so we shall discuss about reproductive system. Reproductive system, it here in many organisms they show sexual dimorphism. So in rabbits also this phenomenon is seen, sexual dimorphism. It refers to male and female sexes are separate and are morphologically different. Sexual means both the sexes, male and female. Di refers to the two sexes which are separate, and also morphologically they show some differences. We can differentiate easily a male animal from a female animal. Such animals are called said to have this sexual dimorphism. So this is male reproductive system. Male reproductive system of rabbit consists of a pair of testes which are ovoid in shape. A pair of testes are present, which are ovoid in shape, and testes are enclosed in a scrotal sac-like structure called scrotal sacs in the abdominal cavity. And each testis is made up of numerous fine tubules called seminiferous tubules. We shall discuss in the next class about the other information. Thank you.